In August 2016, researchers announced they detected a strong, mysterious radio signal about a year earlier. It appeared to be coming from the area around HD 164595, a sun-like star 94 light-years from Earth. The star is trillions and trillions of miles away, but scientists know there's a planet near it that's similar to Neptune. But what they don't know is that there may be other, more habitable Earth-like planets in its orbit as well. The news sparked a lot of public excitement and had people asking, was this a transmission from an alien race? Many scientists were skeptical, but researchers at the organization called the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, or SETI, decided to monitor it further anyway and pointed their array of satellites toward the solar system. The signal turned out to be an earthly disturbance, not a message from the great beyond. But what if by some highly improbable long shot, it would have been a transmission from an alien race? What kind of society would have been able to send a signal from trillions of miles away? To answer this, astronomers often point to the Kardashev scale, developed in 1964 by Russian astrophysicist Nikolai Kardashev. He believed that advanced civilizations could be categorized by the amount of energy they collected and utilized, from type 1 to type 3. Today, there are numerous interpretations of the Kardashev scale that expand on his original meanings to account for advances in science and our own understanding of the world. On Earth, we derive most of our energy from burning fossil fuels, and we aren't yet far enough along to even make it to the type 1 level, which is a civilization capable of harnessing all of the energy available on its own planet through solar, thermal, volcanic, tectonic, and oceanic energy. This civilization would be able to control natural forces, like the climate and earthquakes. Its energy production level would also be 100,000 times more powerful than Earth's current state. A Type 1 civilization near HD 164595 could aim a signal directly at our solar system by harnessing more than a trillion watts, which is about the total energy consumption of all of humankind. Then comes Type 2. This civilization would be capable of controlling the energy of its host star. To do this, they might build what's called a Dyson sphere. This is a megastructure that would enclose the star and harness its power. A Type 2 civilization near HD 164595 could broadcast the signal in all directions, not just at our solar system, by harnessing 100 billion billion watts of power. A Type 3 civilization is the most powerful on the Kardashev scale. It can control and operate on the energy of its entire galaxy. This could be made possible through countless Dyson spheres. This type of civilization would use energy equal to all the starlight produced by one galaxy. Some scientists, not to mention sci-fi writers, have later developed classifications for Type 4 and beyond. These civilizations would have the power to harness so-called extragalactic sources such as dark energy. Though the late legendary Carl Sagan once wrote, quote, "There is no provision for a Type 4 civilization, which by definition talks only to itself." In other words, it would have no interest in trying to establish contact with a civilization as insignificant as ours. But in the end, all of these models could very well be null and void anyway. If aliens do exist out there, they may be way beyond anything we would ever be capable of imagining ourselves.